Good morning and Sai Ram to all my dear children. How are you all? I hope you all are fit and fine at your homes, right? Very good. So children, as you can see on your screen that today is our English turn and we are going to start a new chapter from the book Active English. So all of you, get your active English in your hands with a pencil or pen. We are going to start chapter number 12, The Top of the World 2. Chapter 12, The Top of the World 2. Whatever the word you find difficult, just underline it. And try to find the meaning of that word from dictionary. And make a habit of using dictionary on daily basis. Okay? First of all, we will do the reading. Then we will look the exercises which is given in this chapter. Okay? Let's start reading the chapter. They did not begin to climb the mountain immediately. They made their first camp at the foot of mountain and put up their tents. They stayed there for 3 days while they practiced climbing. Then they started the big climb. So after reading these three lines, you get an idea that this chapter is related to mountains, tracking of mountains. First, they had to cross a very large piece of ice. There were dangerous cracks in it. One of the climbers, Edmund Hillary, with a few companions, climbed over the ice while the others waited in the camp. Hilary and his companions used ladders to cross the crack in the ice. They also cut steps in the ice with their axes. The path was then less dangerous for the others, who had to carry all heavy things. So you know about Edmund Hillary, right? Then they all crossed the ice and made their second camp at a height of over 5,700 meters. They continue in this way for several weeks. Each time Major Hunt chose a small group of men for their climbing abilities. He sent them on in advance for the others who waited in the camp. The advance group found the best place for the next camp and then returned. Then they all moved on to the next camp. This is a very sensible way of climbing. Everyone worked together as a team. Each person did the work he could do best. In this way, they reached a height of 6,600 meters. Then they made a camp. Major Hunt took four companions and climbed as high as they could. They reached 7,800 meters and made another camp. The Major Hunt and another man climbed to 8,205 meters. That is 643 meters from the top. Then they had to return because they had used up nearly all the air they were carrying, but they left some food behind. The next day, Edmund Hillary and one of the men from Nepal called Tenzing Norgay set out. They had to stop climbing. They ate their supper and went to sleep in their little tent on the ice. Early the next morning, 29th May 1953, they started out, and by 11:30 a.m. they had reached the top, the highest place in the world. They felt very proud when they stood there. Then they went down to the camp where their friends greeted them joyfully. Soon the whole world knew of their deed. Mount Everest had been defeated. Man had stood on the top of the world. So children, this chapter is about the journey towards Mount Everest, the journey of Edmund Hillary and Tenzing Norgay. You must have heard these names, that they are the first persons who reached Mount Everest, the highest place in the world, right? This is your homework to read the chapter, to read this chapter number 12, okay, thoroughly. Now we come to exercises. So children, our first exercise, our first question is, put a tick by the true sentences and a cross by the one at the false. Okay, you have to put tick for true statements and cross for false statements. Okay, so the first one is, means these sentences are from the chapter which we had studied. Okay, just now we completed the reading of the chapter, so these sentences are from the chapter. We have to find that which statement is true and which statement or sentence is false. We have to put on true sentences and we have to put cross on false sentences. Alright. So, first one is, when they saw Mount Everest, they at once begin to climb it. In the very first line, if you see in your books, I'm also reading from the book, it is written that they did not begin to climb the mountain immediately. That means this statement is false. We have to put cross. When they saw Mount Everest, they at once begin to climb. No, this is a false statement. Have you put cross in your books? Come on, do it. Now the second one. Their first camp was made at the bottom of the mountain. Their first camp was made at the bottom of the mountain. There is a line in the chapter that they made their first camp at the foot of mountain. Right? So that means this statement is true. We have to put tick. Okay. They practiced climbing for 3 days. They practiced climbing for 3 days. Yes, it is true. It is also written in the chapter that they stayed there for 3 days while they practiced climbing. Okay, the next one is, the large piece of ice was dangerous because there were cracks in it. The large piece of ice was dangerous because there were cracks in it. Yes, this is True. Next, Edmund Hillary was a good climber. Edmund Hillary was a good climber. Yes, of course. This is also true. Next, sending climbers in advance made it safer for others to follow. Sending climbers in advance made it safer for the others to follow. Yes, it is true, because the advance group find the way, best way, and also the best place for the camp, for the next camp, right? So this is statement, the sentence is also true. Now the next one. When the man sent in advance found a good place to camp, they stayed there and waited for the others to arrive. When the man sent in advance found a good place to camp, they stayed there and waited for the others to arrive. No, this is false. The advance group sent to find the good place for the next camp. But after 1 or 2 days, after finding the good place, they returned back. Okay, they not stayed there. Okay. I hope till A to G you all have done in your books. Okay, then moving towards the next. Their second camp was made at the height of almost 5,700 meters. Their second camp was made at the height of almost 5,700 meters. It is true or false? It is true. Most of the climbers did not go higher than 6,600 meters. Most of the climbers did not go higher than 6,600 meters. It is false. It is no. This statement, this sentence is not mentioned in the chapter. So this is a false statement. Five climbers reached 8,205 meters. Five climbers reached 8,205 meters. No. The line is there in the chapter that the Major Hunt and other man climbed to 8,205 meters. So this statement is also false. Wrong. Done. The next one. Major Hunt reached a height of 643 meters from the top. Major Hunt reached the height of 643 meters from the top. Yes, this is true. Next, Hillary and Tenzing reached a height of 8,370 meters on 28 May. No, it is false. Last one. After Hillary and Tenzing reached the top of the Everest, the other men also climbed to the top. Yes. This last one is false. It is written that in the last paragraph of the chapter that they felt very proud when they stood there. Then they went down to the camp where their friends greeted them joyfully. So moving towards the next exercise, that is Yes, children, our second exercise, second question is change each sentence in two ways. We have to change the sentence in two ways. First, use not as. We have to use not as. Then, when we are making the second sentence, we have to use less than. Okay, we have to use two things. Not as, and second thing is less than. Using these two words, we have to form two different sentences, but we don't have to change the meaning of the sentence which is given to us. Okay, let's see the example. First one, we have to change into these two sentences. The first sentence is, a puppy is more playful than an old dog. A puppy is more playful than an old dog. First of all, what we have to use? Not as. Okay, how we have changed the sentence? An old dog is not as playful as puppy. Okay, we have to use as two times. Okay, we have to use as two times. And old, like in similes, we use as bright as small as thin as. Like this, we have to use as two times. An old dog is not as playful as a puppy. And the second sentence, less than, in this, an old dog is less playful than a puppy. An old dog is less playful than a puppy. Okay? In this way, we have to change the sentence. What sentence is given to us? A puppy is more playful than an old dog. An old dog is not as playful as a puppy. The second way, an old dog is less playful than a puppy. Now we have to see the second sentence, that is, a knife is more dangerous than a pair of scissors. A knife is more dangerous than a pair of scissors. How we have to change it? A pair of scissors is not as dangerous as a knife. A pair of scissors is not as dangerous as a knife. In this sentence, we have used not as dangerous as. Okay, now the second sentence. A pair of scissors is less dangerous than a knife. A pair of scissors is less dangerous than a knife. Okay. First of all, we have to change the sentence, but we don't have to change the meaning of the sentence. We have to use not as and less than. Okay, now the exercise. So children, our first sentence is, the first path was more difficult than the second path. The first path was more difficult than the second path. So how we have to change these? By using not as and less than. First one. The second path was not as difficult as the first path. We don't have to change the meaning. The second path was not as difficult as the first path. Okay, this is done. Now the second we have to use less than. The second path was less difficult than the first path. The second path was less difficult than the first path. So meaning of these two sentences are same as the given in the question, right? We only have to use not as and what? Less than. Okay? But we don't have to change the meaning of the sentences. Okay? Now the next one. Seema's book is more exciting than Saleem's book. Seema's book is more exciting than Saleem's book. We have to change the sentence. Saleem's book is not exciting, not as exciting as Seema's book. Saleem's book is not as exciting as Seema's book. Okay? Second, Saleem's book is less exciting than Seema's book. Saleem's book is less exciting than Seema's book. Okay? Both the sentences are clear. That how we have to use not as and how we have to use less than. Okay? Now I hope you will do the rest on your own. Right? Moving on the next question. So children, in question number 3, what we have to do? Write each sentence in another way. The way we have done in the previous sentence, here also we have to do in the same way. Again, we don't have to change the meaning of the sentence. And you are given the beginning of each new sentence. The beginning of each new sentence. That how you have to start or begin the sentence, the new sentence. First one, an old dog is not as playful as a puppy. The example of first question, an old dog is not as playful as a puppy. So we have to start the new sentence from the word a puppy. A puppy is more playful than an old dog. The meaning of the sentence is same, right? A puppy is more playful than an old dog, right? The second sentence. A gun is more dangerous than a knife. A gun is more dangerous than a knife. How we have to start the sentence? A knife is less. A knife is less dangerous than a gun. A knife is less dangerous than a gun. Understood how you have to do? In all the questions, the beginning of the sentence, of the new sentence is already given. So you have to write accordingly. Okay? The C point is, a thunderstorm is less dangerous than a cyclone. A thunderstorm is less dangerous than a cyclone. The starting is given, a thunderstorm is not, a thunderstorm is not as dangerous as a cyclone. A thunderstorm is not as dangerous as a cyclone. All right. In these sentences, I have uses a puppy, a knife is less, a thunderstorm. So means these words are already given that how you have to start the new sentence without changing the meaning of each and every sentence. Okay. This is also as same as question number 1, which we have done. Question number 2. Okay. I hope you all understood the chapter as well as the exercises that how you have to do. Okay? Sairam.